Tailscale is a wonderful WireGuard VPN-based tunneling and SD-WAN technology that is incredibly easy to set up, and it's absolutely free to use for up to 100 devices. We've been digging into Tailscale a lot lately, and Crosstalk's network genius David is actually working on a full Tailscale overview and tutorial, so be sure to subscribe so that you don't miss it. In this video, however, I'm going to show you just how easy it is to set up Tailscale with a GL.iNet travel router. Now, this is the perfect solution if you're always on the road, but you need connectivity back to your home or office, and Tailscale is built right into these tiny little routers. So here's the diagram of what we're gonna be setting up, and this is the general idea here, right? We're at a hotel, and we wanna be able to remote desktop back to our PC at home. This also works if you have services at home that you wanna access. Also going the other direction through the tunnel, we brought along a server for some reason, right? And we're running a service on it. This is just an example, but in this case, we've got Open Speed Test Server that we wanna be able to connect to from any other device that's in our tailnet. And what's a tailnet, you ask? Well, a tailnet is basically just a private network that consists of all of the devices that you've configured with your Tailscale credentials. And when I told you earlier that Tailscale is free up to 100 devices, the tailnet is where all of those devices connect in and talk to each other. Each device in the tailnet gets its own IP in that private network, and then you can configure which users have access to, you know, which devices and services are in that same network. It's all pretty cool. Okay, I have links down in the description to everything that I'm talking about in this video, and as always, we've got a lot to cover, so let's get started. If you don't want to constantly pause and unpause this video, I have also created a blog post that goes over everything that I'm doing here, but it's written down, right, so that you can follow along at your own pace, and there's a link down in the description to that blog post. So, this right here is the Barrel AX from GL.iNet. It's my absolute favorite travel router, and I take it with me anytime I'm on the road. I did a full video on how to set these up start to finish, so I'll also be sure to link that video in the description, along with a link to this device, which is awesome, by the way, and you should definitely buy one. But I should mention that while I'm doing this setup with the Barrel AX, every GL.iNet router that I've worked with has the exact same interface, so this should work with any of their routers. But Tailscale is labeled as a beta feature, so if you don't see it, you may need to upgrade to the latest version. To get started, you're going to need to head over to tailscale.com to sign up. Now, Tailscale is completely free for personal use up to 100 devices and 3 users. They give you a number of different ways to authenticate, including identity providers such as Google and Microsoft, Apple, GitHub, so pick whichever one you want, and then you'll be walked through the authentication. Once you authenticate and log into Tailscale for the first time, it's going to pop up a wizard that is going to walk you through the initial setup of whatever device you first connected with. So for example, if you're on Windows, it's going to have you download the Windows client. If you're on Linux or Mac, it'll have you download those specific clients. Now, for my laptop that I've got right here that I'm using for this demonstration, I've already logged into Tailscale. I don't have that initial wizard anymore, so I'm just going to add this machine manually. Now, to do that, from the admin GUI of Tailscale, right under machines here, we can see I don't have any machines listed now. I'm gonna click on Windows. We're gonna download the latest EXE. Click on it, agree to the terms, install. And then it's gonna redirect me to log in with whatever identity provider I chose. In my case, I'm using Google. Okay, connecting the device, and we can see that login is successful. So now, if I go back to the admin GUI for Tailscale, I can see that my machine is listed as the only machine in that particular tailnet. And that's it. That is literally as easy as it is to get any sort of, you know, Windows PC or Mac or Linux device connected into Tailscale. Now, doing it at the router level is going to be a little bit different, so let's go ahead and tackle that next. The first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch my laptop over to the wireless of the Barrel AX, and I'm going to log into the admin GUI. And since I haven't changed the default IP scheme on the Barrel AX, the admin GUI can be found at 192.168.8.1. And now that I've logged into the Barrel AX, now this is already completely set up because this is the one that I personally use when I'm traveling. Again, I've got a full setup video for the Barrel AX online, link down in the description. But for now, I'm gonna go over to Applications, and then down here we have Tailscale. So we're gonna click this button to enable Tailscale. and click apply. So we've added the Tailscale service to the Barrel AX, but we haven't configured it yet. So what we need to do here, the Tailscale service is enabled, but the device is not bound yet, meaning we haven't authenticated to our tailnet yet. Please bind this device to your Tailscale account using this device bind link. So we're gonna click this link right here. And that pops up a second window that has a link for Tailscale with a code at the end here. We're gonna click on that. And it's gonna ask if we wanna connect this device to our tailnet. If you're not logged in, by the way, it will ask you to log in first. In our case though, we're just gonna say connect and log in successful. So now let's go back again to the admin GUI of Tailscale. And now we can see that there are two separate devices listed. And now these devices are both part of that same tailnet, that same Tailscale private network. Now notice here that it says that the Barrel AX has an older version that you should update. OpenWRT is what runs in the back end of these GL.iNet devices. I haven't found this to be an issue. I don't think there's a way to update the software on the Barrel AX itself, but it works just fine even though it's telling us that we should update. And I assume at some point they're gonna come out with a new version of the GL.iNet GUI that will have the latest Tailscale client installed. Okay, so we are connected. Let's go ahead and actually disconnect. I'm gonna disconnect my laptop here from the Barrel AX network so we can be sure that I'm not accessing the services back and forth on the same network. I wanna be on completely separate networks to do that. Okay, so I have now reconnected my laptop to my home Wi-Fi here and not the Wi-Fi of the Barrel AX. Now, if you look at the Barrel AX in the Tailscale GUI, you can see here that we have an IP address for the Barrel AX. So if I put that IP address into my browser window here on my Windows PC, there we go, 100.99.210.95, I can get to the admin portal of this Barrel AX, but I am not yet able to get to any services running behind that firewall, right? I can get to the front of the firewall, to the admin GUI of the GL.iNet, but I can't get to anything behind it yet. So let's fix that next. So first things first, I'm going to go back to the Tailscale application, and right here it says allow remote access LAN. I'm going to enable it, basically saying, yes, allow devices that are authenticated in my tailnet to access the LAN devices behind the Barrel AX. And we're gonna apply that setting. And now back in the Tailscale admin GUI, I need to find the GL.iNet device. And then I wanna click these three dots right here. And I wanna do edit route settings. Now, when I click edit route settings, it already knows the local LAN subnet of that Barrel AX since I've advertised it within the GL.iNet software. So all we have to do is check that box to allow devices in the tailnet to route through the front end of the Barrel AX and then into the back end LAN, which is 192.168.8.0/24. We're gonna go ahead and save that setting. Okay, so now my laptop is connected to my home wireless. The Barrel AX is on its own separate internet connection, but I should be able to, from my laptop through the tailnet, hit the speed test server that's located on this little server that I've got right here. And that speed test server runs at 192.168.8.150 on port 3000. We're gonna say continue, and there we have open speed test. So I was successfully able to route from my laptop through the tailnet, separate internet connection, and then all the way over here through the GL.iNet Barrel AX, and then onto the services that this server provides. Now, of course, OpenSpeedTest is just an example. This could be any services that are running behind this little device, or it could be a remote desktop connection. It could be whatever you need to access behind the router. More importantly, if we want to be able to remote desktop, so that's my use case, right? When I'm on the road, I wanna take this router, I wanna plug it into whatever hotel I'm staying at, whatever internet connections that I find, and I want it to connect out to that tailnet so that I can remote desktop to my home PC. Now, of course, to enable the ability to connect into Windows with remote desktop, you need to have Windows 10 or 11 Pro. You can't do it with the home version. So it's not gonna work with this laptop. This laptop is actually the home version, but I do have it set up on my regular desktop, which is a Windows 10 Pro machine. And there's only a couple of considerations that you need to think about when you're connecting into remote desktop. All of this is in the blog post, by the way. So first thing, you need to enable remote desktop on the Windows PC such that incoming connections can come in and actually use remote desktop on that system. Then you also need to enable RDP through the Windows firewall, right? And so again, I have instructions here for how to do that. And then finally, I don't know if everyone's gonna run into this same exact issue, but I authenticate to my Windows machine through remote desktop with my Microsoft account, right? That single sign-in Microsoft login. And it didn't work for me the first time that I tried it, and I couldn't figure out why it wasn't authenticating. Until I found this article right here. This is from a couple years ago, but it says remote desktop not working with Microsoft account. And if you scroll down, this is what fixed it for me. So you have to run this in the run window, run as user Microsoft account, blah, blah, blah. And then you put in an email address and then WinVer. So for whatever reason, again, I didn't look into why this command works, why this magic command does the magic that it does, but this command did work for me, and I do have a link to that in the blog post if you are trying to connect and authenticate with your Microsoft account, but it's not actually working. So there you have it, a quick and easy way to set up Tailscale to allow your GL.iNet travel router to connect with your home or business network when you're on the road. And I cannot tell you how impressed I was the first time that I set this up. This entire project takes no more than 10 minutes start to finish, even if you've never done it before. Very cool. Okay, that's it for this video. Make sure you subscribe to Crosstalk Solutions for more Tailscale content. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my recent video on Starlink versus 5G for remote internet. And the bottom video is our adventures in setting up a complete wireless network for an 1800s era silver mining ghost town.